let's just begin with our invocation and go straight into moving. Towards the one, the perfection of love, harmony, and beauty, the only being, united with all the illuminated souls who form the embodiment of the Master, the message, the mystery, the miracle, the mother, the spirit of guidance. That could be a whole thing, couldn't it? Saying the invocation according to every festival, how that would look. Well, Salik's going to kick us off.
Let's start with this dance that resonates with the rising energy of life at this time of year. Yahai!
Yahai!
Yahuk!
Yahuk!
Yahai, divine life. Yahuk, the manifestation of that life. Truth, divine truth is the common translation, so that in this dance we can think of ourselves as being full of that life and then manifesting that divine life force through our being. And I was thinking earlier on, what is this divine life? You know, what gives us life? The energy that we have in our bodies all comes from the sun. All of it. Because it's coming from the plants, ultimately, which comes from the sun. So the life that animates us, animates our bodies, is sun energy. Right. Yahai, yahuk.
Yahai, yahuk.
Very simple. Yahai, yahuk. Yahai, yahuk. Yahai. And we have various movements to do with it. So you can do, you can stand and do this, or you can do some of them sitting as well. So largely involves raising the arms and lowering the arms. So you can do that sitting down. So really, and what I invite you, when you're raising your arms, really to stretch, to throw them upwards, because when we put energy and enthusiasm and full power, can't quite find the right words, into our movements, we can feel something. We're more likely to feel a change. We're more likely to resonate with a different kind of energy. Rather than,
more fire.
More fire, quite. And when we bring our arms down, bring them down with energy again, connecting with the earth, manifesting in this body.
Could even feel your heels and your feet really connecting with the earth when you do that. So this real sense of landing on the planet.
And if you're standing, because we're not moving in a circle, let's just keep pacing. Let's keep moving our feet, connecting with the earth. So we're using our whole bodies.
Beating the drum.
Beating
of
the drum.
Earth.
Yeah. So we'll be. Yeah, I think just, I'll call out the movements, all right. And then what we do is we do it at the speed we've just done it, and then I'll call out double time and we double the speed, and then I double again and we double it again, just for a little bit, and then we'll stop. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. One more time. Ya hi. Ya huck. Just noticing your breath, noticing your heartbeat, noticing the energy in your body, the temperature. If there's been any change. And just letting the breath settle, letting the body settle again. Feeling that aliveness. Ya hi, ya huck. Power of the sun rising in our bodies.
So we're going to go pretty well straight on to a Beltane dance. The fires of Beltane kindle the night, reflecting the green man's glance.
The fires of Beltane kindle the night, reflecting the green man's glance.
His lady, the queen of the May, delights us all with her spiral dance.
His lady, the queen of the May, delights us all with her spiral dance.
Follow me to the source of all, he says. I am eternal fire.
Follow me to the source of all, he says. I am eternal fire.
Come with me to the source of all, she says. I am your heart's desire.
Come with me to the source of all, she says. I am your heart's desire. And I was just reflecting, you know, I was talking about the sun and the sun's energy, but without the earth, we wouldn't have any of this. We wouldn't have our bodies. We wouldn't have all this wonderful greening that's going on around us. So it's that we need them both working together.
I'm glad you said that.
And all sorts of other things too. Right, what chord am I playing?
See. The fires of Beltane kindle the night, reflecting the green man's glance. His lady, the queen of the bay, delights us all with the spiral dance. Follow me to the source of all, she says, I am eternal.
Reflecting the green man's glance, his lady, the queen of the May, delights us all with her spiral dance. Follow me to the source of all, he says, I am eternal fire. Come with me to the source of all, she says, I am your heart's desire. Reflecting the green man's glance, his lady, the queen of the bay, delights us all with her spiral dance. Follow me to the source of all, he says, I am eternal fire. Come with me to the source of all, she says, I am your heart's desire.
So really, yes, feeling these energies of sun and moon or sun and earth and masculine and feminine that need to, feminine. Sounds like some kind of weird I don't know, drug.
Right.
Excuse us. Anyway, this blending of masculine and feminine energies, which are both needed, as Salik was saying, you know, we can't have all the fertility of the earth, we can't have all of the baby birds and animals being born, we can't have all of the plants seeding themselves and growing without this interplay of masculine and feminine, sun and earth, sun and moon, father and mother.
Life and death.
Life and death, as you were saying this morning, none of the life happens without the death. It's like all of the compost, which is nourishing the growth, it only exists because other beings have died and are being composted. So plants, animals, microorganisms, it's all part of this one great rich cycle of life. And really in that way, it's a very concrete sense of that we're all one, you know. We can't do it without anything else, without any of it. Shall we do some movements?
Yeah.
Right.
I'm ready now.
Calmed down enough. So it's a partner dance, and it's quite a vigorous partner dance. We'd be taking our first partner by the right arm and spinning together, turning on, turning to the right. So the fires of Beltane kindle the night, and then you turn on your own,
reflecting the green dance lights.
So this sense of connection of this partnership, and also the individual experience of the green man. I took photographs the other day of ivy climbing up a tree. It just looked like a green man to me. It was like, you know, how do we experience the green man in nature right now at the moment? And then our next partner we meet with our left arm. There we are, there's the green man. Beautiful.
Mm,
thank you, Margot. And taking with our left arm and turning the other way is Lady.
We are the maid, delights us all with a spiral dance.
So again, this interaction with a partner, experiencing the feminine, experiencing the Queen of the May, and then also our own individual internal experience of that. So very much in partnership and then alone. And of course, the turn to the right we normally associate with the sun. So you could just do a sun turn if you wanted and really connect with that, with those sun-like, radiant, masculine energies. And the turn to the left associated with the moon. So we can bring in those moon-like, some of the more feminine qualities. So that's the first part. Right, then you get to choose, because I'm very advanced in my gender politics. So you get to choose whether you resonate at the moment with the male or the female, the masculine or the feminine. So whoever resonates with the green man gets to stride forward in this fiery, confident way. Follow me to the source of all, he says, I am eternal fire. Or if you're feeling more in resonance with the Queen of the May, you can be this seductive energy, this very this is the time of great fertility, so it's impossible to avoid a kind of certain sexuality going on here, because that's what it's all about. You know, basically it's all about sex and death, isn't it? Come with me to the source of all, she says, I am your heart's desire. So, you know, you can choose one or the other, or you can do both. That's entirely up to you. So, because of course, all of these energies can be found in anybody. So that's just the way, it's what we choose to focus on in any particular time. Here we go, turning with the green man, choosing a partner. The fires of Beltane kindle the night, protecting the green man's glance. His lady, the queen of the maid, lights us all in a spiral dance. Follow me to the source of all, he says, I am your heart's thrill. I am eternal fire.
Going well today.
Come with me to the source of all, she says, I am your heart's desire. The fires of Beltane kindle the night, reflecting the green man's glance. His lady, the queen of the maid, lights us all in the spiral dance. Come with me to the source of all, I am eternal fire.
Come with me to the source of all, she says, I am your heart's desire.
The lights of Beltane kindle the night, reflecting the green man's glance. It's maybe the queen of the maid, it lights us all in the spiral dance.
Follow me to the source of all, I am eternal fire.
Come with me to the source of all, she says, I am your heart's desire. Fires of Beltane kindle the night, reflecting the green man's glance. His lady, the lady of the maid, lights us all in the spiral dance.
Follow me to the source of all, she says, I am your heart's desire.
of all, she says, I am your heart's desire.
One more time.
The fires of Beltane kindle the night, reflecting the green man's blood. His lady, the queen of the May, delights us all in a final dance. Follow me to the source of all, he says, I am eternal fire. Come with me to the source of all, she says, I am your heart's desire.
So sit down and relax for a moment and just allow ourselves to feel those spiraling energies within us. The eternal fire rising, leading the way. All the growth following the growing sun at this time of year, and the holding, nourishing, fertile mother.
Beautiful.
Beautiful, gorgeous, queen of the May. Come, come with me. I am your heart's desire. Do that one actually.
Sorry, I didn't think it was quite in tune. I think maybe it is.
So I'd like to share yet another dance, and then we're going to go into some more practice and some sharing and some a little bit of ritual after that. So this is a dance which I'd completely forgotten about. I woke up with it in my head the other day and I hadn't thought about it at all for about 15 years or more. So here are the words. Deeper, deeper into the heart of love.
Deeper. Deeper into the heart of love.
Letting go into the mystery.
Letting go into the mystery.
Letting go into the mystery. Rising in love.
Letting go into the mystery. Rising in love.
So we've got twice the deeper, deeper into the heart of love, and then three times letting go into the mystery. And once rising in love. So this is how it goes. If you could give me my chord. Deeper, deeper into the heart of love. Deeper, deeper into the heart of love. Letting go into the mystery. Letting go into the mystery. Letting go into the mystery. Rising in love. Deeper, deeper into the heart of love. Deeper, deeper into the heart of love. Letting go into the mystery. Letting go into the mystery. Letting go into the mystery. Rising. So somehow it feels right at the moment to be doing quite a lot of energizing, activating of the body. It's part of the season, but if you need to take it more gently and stay seated, then feel free. Just these movements are rather lovely standing. So we're going to do this kind of digging deeper, deeper, and then bringing it back into the heart. Into the heart of love. Deeper, deeper. Into the heart of love. So just to clarify, I'm stepping forward as I dig, and stepping forward again, and then stepping back, bringing it into my heart. Deeper, deeper. Into the heart of love again. Deeper, deeper. Into the heart of love. Now letting go, turning to the left. Letting go. Letting go into the mystery of the way. Letting go into the mystery of the way. Letting go into the mystery.
Letting go into the mystery.
So let's take some time just to let go into that mystery. The mystery of breath, the mystery of the body, the mystery of life, the mystery of death. And let's call upon this self, this I, which is inhabiting this body. And let's allow our consciousness, our self, to wander, to take its attention throughout this physical form, noticing the feet and how they meet the earth. Noticing all the long bones in the body and how they're keeping us upright. Noticing the beautiful tower of the spine, this column of delicate yet beautiful and strong bones, fiercely protecting the spinal cord. Let's take our attention into the muscles which function so beautifully, enabling our arms and legs to move, to carry us about. The legs bending and straightening, allowing us to climb stairs, to climb hills, to walk in beautiful places in nature, the arms bending and straightening, and the fingers moving, enabling us to pick up and hold things and to put them down again, to draw our beloveds close to us and hold them in a hug. And the wonderful fluid movements that these muscles enable us to make. And then let's take our attention to the blood that's pulsing around our bodies and to the pulsing of the heart, pumping it round this warm, fiery heat and red of the blood, carrying life force to every cell of the bodies, renewing with more life, with more oxygen, and taking away the waste products, so that we're constantly renewed, rebuilt, refilled with new life. And again, taking our conscious awareness to the breath, the miracle of the bellows of the lungs drawing in the air and letting it out again, this wonderful exchange of gases, new life coming in, the releasing of what's no longer useful on the out-breath. And the way that this breath is intimately connected with the breath of every being on this beautiful planet of ours. And in our imagination, we can stand in front of a tree honoring with gratitude the breath of the tree. Tree which breathes in the carbon dioxide that we breathe out. This is what feeds its green growth. And then she breathes out the oxygen that we can breathe in. This wonderful interdependence, feeding each other with breath. Breath that we share with every other human being on the planet, and every other being that breathes oxygen, and with all of the plant brothers and sisters who need the carbon dioxide to live and grow and flourish. Let's take our conscious awareness deeper into the body of the earth, deeper, deeper. And let's acknowledge and give thanks for all of the elements, the building blocks of these bodies we are inhabiting, which came from Mother Earth. Nothing in our bodies that didn't come from the earth. All of the minerals, the atoms, the molecules, and we know that every few years, every one of these cells in our bodies is renewed, shed, given back to the earth, new life brought in. New minerals, new vitamins in our food, in our breath, fresh water. Drink or take in with our food, or we bathe in. Our bodies are not separate from the earth. We are made of earth, and to the earth we will return. These bodies, we'll give them back when we've done with them, to be reabsorbed, composted, to provide nourishment for new growth, for new life. So just as our bodies are not separate from Earth, they're subject to the same cycles that the Earth goes through. So we can feel these turning cycles of the year, the wheel of the year turning, reflected in our own bodies. And this greening, burning, rising fire of life, which is all around us in the Northern Hemisphere at this time of year, our bodies are experiencing that too. We can really open to it and let it flow and rise through us, bringing creative life force, bringing fire to all of our longings and yearnings, all of our creativity. Maybe it's actually giving birth to children or growing babies, but maybe it's growing projects, growing creative ideas, artistic, intellectual, spiritual abundance, fired and nourished by the rising fire and life of Beltane. So let's take a few more breaths, breathing deeper into the heart of love, into the heart of life. This rising life of the mother rising through each one of our bodies. Blessed be.
Blessed be.
So we're going to move into a space where those hopes and dreams and ideas can be given some voice, be given some fire, given some direction to move with, riding on this wave of greening, growing life. So we'll begin with a dance which helps us with that, and then we'll come into a sharing space where you'll be invited to give a voice to some of your heart's yearning. The wheel of the year is turning.
The wheel of the year is turning.
And the Beltane fires are burning.
And the Beltane fires are burning.
So give your hand.
So give your hand.
And take your brand.
And take your brand.
To kindle your own heart's yearning.
To kindle your own heart's yearning.
So is it hearth or is it heart? The tradition at this time of year in the Celtic lands was that the fires in the homes would be put out. Everything would be cleaned and made new, and then a communal fire would be lit in the heart of the community. Sometimes two fires, sometimes the cattle would be driven between the fires. People would jump the fires to purify themselves and to bring that fire energy to their projects, to their relationships, to their marriages, to their futures. And then every household would take a burning brand, a stick with a flame on it, from this communal Beltane fire and bring it back to the hearth of each home to kindle a new fire, a new blessed fire for the year to come. So here we're invited to take this brand and use it to kindle, yes, our hearth, but also our heart's yearning. Here's the melody. The wheel of the year is turning, and the Beltane fires are burning. So give your hand and take your brand to kindle your own heart's yearning. The wheel of the year is turning, and the Beltane fires are burning. So give your hand and take your brand to kindle your own heart's yearning. Can you take it back one or two? Yeah, two. Thank you very much. That would be nicer.
The wheel of the year is turning, and the Beltane fires are burning. So give your hand and take your breath.
I invite you to move a little bit, if you choose. Normally we'd be dancing this, we'd make a wheel with a group of us, so we'd all have our right hands facing towards the centre of the of this little circle, and we would be holding hands in the middle. The hands are the hub of the wheel. I can show the view like this. If you imagine us all, you're all placing your hands on top of Salik's and my hands. And then we're just turning.
The wheel of the year is turning, and the Beltane fires are burning.
So feeling that turning of the year, feeling the rising of the each festival that we've been through, each changing season, arriving at this point where we are now with the Beltane fires burning. And then, so give your hand, you put your other hand into the circle, palm up.
So give your hand.
And then we each take our brand from this burning fire.
And take your brand.
And then we'll just gently warm it at our hearts, kindling our heart's yearning, taking it back to this home of our body. Finding the hearth in there where we can nurture our heart's yearning. So you might just want to wander about a bit. There's a little bit of extra music and you can just reflect on what your heart's yearning is right now.
To kindle your own heart's yearning.
There we go. So let's put our right hands, and we're going to imagine that we are taking hands. We can feel the weight of each other's right hands is forming this strong hub of our wheel as together our community turns through the wheel of the year.
The wheel of the year is turning, and the Beltane fires are burning. So to kindle your own heart's yearning. The wheel of the year is turning, and the mountain fires are burning. So give your
So keeping in this space, this energy, kindling our heart's yearning, come in close. And let's allow this breathing, greening, rising fire of Beltane to bring life to these yearnings of our hearts. And I invite you to unmute and to name what your heart's yearning is at this time. What is it that's rising up in you? These longings, these hopes, these dreams, ideas, creative projects, gardens, gardens of the heart. giving voice to these yearnings is the first step to bringing them into being. Well,
I was thinking maybe we'll say another Yahai Yafatah for those thoughts and dreams and plans that people are holding in their hearts right now.
Yeah, let's come from this place of kindling, feeling the brand, the fire of Beltane in our hearts, connecting with the earth, feeling those rising energies. This is the time. This is the time for all of the buds to burst open in their own good time. Some of them sooner than others. The rising, greening fire, abundance of being. Let's bring all of that, all of our hopes and dreams and yearnings and longings, bringing them out so they can be seen and met and grow with Yahai and Yafatah. Yahai. Yafatah. So may it be. Seal this with our closing dance. Which would you like to do? There are two choices there. What feels good to you?
Sri Ram.
Lovely. Good.
You're going to lead it.
Am I?
Yes, because you led it the other day. And Jilani was showing me these wonderful movements, which she's...
This is the Beltane variation of Sri Ram.
This, it's a wonderful dance, but it's a partner dance, and it's quite hard to find a way of doing it on Zoom that works. We've done it a couple of times, but then she was showing me these movements yesterday. It was like, yes, yes, wonderful.
Kind of spontaneously evolved during Songs of One Breath on Friday, so.
Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram.
Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram.
Om.
Om. It's this wonderful, radiant, sunny, shiny, the sounds and the phrase and the meanings.
All power and strength and victory to the radiant one, the radiant part of our being, to all that is manifest and unmanifest, all that is seen and unseen. Om.
All of this work really comes down to manifesting and bringing through more of who we really are, what is our true nature, this self-acceptance that we talk about, self-acceptance of this is how it is, and understanding of the miracle that we are, each one of us. And actually it's the same miracle, we're all the same miracle. The many faces of the one being. And if you can see the radiance of that one being in somebody else, you can learn to recognize that as a mirror of your own radiance.
Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Om. Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Om.
Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Om.
just another tiny bit of, I don't know what to call it really, it's not guidance or teaching, but it's something that, that has come through my experience, is that when I dare to show more of who I am, then exponentially I receive more love, more trust, more recognition.
More healing.
But it's like I'm thinking about this in the interaction between people, actually. So I'm thinking, when I dare to show you more of who I am, then I receive more of who you are. And so this is the mystery that, you know, there's so many of us, well, all of us, I think, actually have this, I dare to say, all of us have this yearning for more love, more intimacy, more connection. And paradoxically, the quickest way to that is through being more of who we are. And so much of our training and education was to hide who we are in order to be acceptable.
Mm.
But actually, it doesn't work like that.
A cost. Great cost.
Yeah. And so if we can use this dance as a practice, to practice radiating this true essence of my nature, each one of us. You don't have to radiate my nature.
I'd love to be able to radiate your nature, Jilani.
Oh, I'd love beautiful. You to radiate your nature more, because it's beautiful. You know, this is the thing. It's like, yeah, trusting that our own radiance is what it takes. And that ultimately, anyway, it's all the same radiance. Oh, so shining forth with all of who you are, daring to be you, beautiful you. So here are these movements that I've evolved, coming from the heart, radiating. And we can do it slightly to the right, and then slightly to the left, and then turning and bowing. So it looks like this.
Shri Ram, Jai Ram.
Turning right.
Jai Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Ram.
close and let's look in the mirror. Look at these radiant, shining, beautiful faces and recognize that that radiance, that same radiance, shines from you too. Even though you might not see it, we do. If you can recognize it, it's one step on the way. And how beautifully does the divine manifest to me through you, each one of you today, in this moment. Dear beloved, radiant hearts, companions on this path deeper into the heart of love. May all of the greening, burning, fiery power of Beltane be with you and bring life and energy to your yearnings, your longings, your hopes, your dreams, your heart's desire. So may it be. Blessed
so may
be.
Blessed be.